Faith is to believe what you do not see. The reward of this faith is to see what you believe, says St. Augustine. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today the reading from the Gospel begins like this. The apostle said to the Lord, "Increase our faith." It seems that we can all make this our invocation, especially during our life journey or even every day of our life. Let us too, like the apostles, say to the Lord, "Increase our faith." Yes, Lord, our faith is small, our faith is weak, but we offer it to you as it is, so that you can make it grow. Would it be good to say this all together? Shall we repeat together? Lord, increase our faith. Shall we, everyone? Lord, increase our faith. Lord, increase our faith. Lord, increase our faith. And make it grow. Why did the disciple request or ask Jesus? What prompted the disciple to make this unusual request? Increase their faith. To understand that, we need to go back to previous passages in Luke's Gospel, chapter 15 and 16, and even the beginning of 17th chapter. The parables about the prodigal son, the lost coin, the lost sheep, the dishonest steward, Lazarus and the rich man. And 17th chapter, Jesus speaking about the sin and also forgiveness. Together, they point to a reality that God's ways are different from our ways. They remind us that if we are to be faithful disciples, then we must take our quill not from the world, but from Christ, who reveals to us the very mind of God. And how does the Lord answer us? He responds in today's Gospel, "If you had faith as a size of mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, 'Be uprooted up and be planted in the sea,' it would obey." Even in Matthew's Gospel, Jesus speaks about if we have the size of the mustard seed faith, if you say this mountain, and mountain will be moved because of your faith. Jesus is not talking literally about the mountain or about the tree. He is talking about something, the mountains and trees in our lives. There are mountains of sins, and there are many things that we face in our daily lives. Addiction, depression, and some people, they have the mountain of anger and loneliness, and sometimes guilt, sometimes shame, and lot of things, all the mountains we have, and we struggle in our daily lives, and we don't think that will be removed from our life, thrown into sea, we continue our journey with the mountains and suffer and live our life with sadness and with the tears. And Jesus says, if we have the faith of the mustard seed, if you say that mountain or the tree, and it will removed and thrown into the sea, if we have that quality, the faith of the mustard seed, the mountains that you have surely will be removed, dear brothers and sisters. Believe that. If you don't believe, come to me, I will teach you. Come to me, I will remove all the mountains and throw them into the sea. The mustard seed is tiny. And Jesus says that faith this size, small but true and sincere, suffices to achieve what is humanly impossible, unthinkable. And it is true, we all know people who are simple and humble, but whose faith is so strong, it can move mountains. Even just a little faith will enable the follower of Jesus to do wondrous things. But this uplifting and inspiring teaching is quietly followed by the second teaching, a caution about knowing one's place in God's plan. The disciples of Jesus are to be understand themselves as servants to God and to His plans. Even God works through us with our mustard seed sized faith. We must not seek praise. Our participation in God's plans is God's grace to us, nothing more, nothing less. When we are grace enough to cooperate with God, the work we do is nothing more than our obligation to God as faithful stewards. And yet, our faith enables us to believe that what we have offered in service to God as His servants can be made to produce a hundredfold. Look at our Mother Mary, the great mother of faith. At the Annunciation, after listening to angel, Luke chapter 1, verse 38, then Mary said, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me as you have said. Dear brothers and sisters, in the first reading, the prophet Habakkuk speaks about, at the end, we hear, but the just one, because of faith, shall live. And Bible also speaks many things about faith. Through faith, we are healed. Through faith, we are saved. And when the faith and grace, they meet, then the healing will take place. Sometimes we are disgraced because the fear enters into our lives. When the fear is there, so we cannot trust God. When you have the faith, fear runs away from our heart. My dear brothers and sisters, having faith in God, everything is possible with God. One life story I would like to bring to you. A saintly man who lived in the year 1182 to 1226, in between. He lived only 44 years. Francis of Assisi. As a young man, he was in the military, and then he became a prisoner. When he was a prisoner, he saw all the persecutions, all the people suffering there, and that was the turning point in his life. Then when he came back, once he was in the church praying, he heard the voice from the crucifix. He heard the voice. God spoke with him. God said through crucifix, "Restore my house," which is falling ruin. Three times Francis of Assisi heard the voice from the crucifix, "Restore my house, which is falling ruin." When he heard, he believed that. When he heard, he completely trusted that this voice is from God. Then he began working on that. He collected money and he started building, restoring the church. And he did two churches like that. And when he had a faith of the mustard seed within his heart, humble man with a simple city, he wanted to respond to the voice of God. Then he started working on that. Again he heard from the gospel, Jesus talking about, when you do the mission work, go, no money, no silver, no gold, and no bag. When he heard, he obeyed that. He embraced the poverty. He left, he renounced everything, and he continuously searching and seeking God because his faith of the mustard seed, like a small size, began responding to God's voice. Then he became a saint, and even recently we celebrated his feast, dear brothers and sisters. What a great saint we have in our Catholic Church, who believed, who trusted, who saw the vision of God in his life. Even he received the stigmata, and even he is encouraging many people to have that fire to respond to God's call. And today, in the responsorial psalm, we heard a beautiful sentence. If today you hear the voice of God, harden not your heart. Today you hear the voice of God, harden not your heart. Dear brothers and sisters, every day we hear, when we have faith, what happens? The fear will disappear. And even when you face all the troubles and problems and everything, even you can smile at that moment. You can laugh because you know you have the living God. You have God who will protect you. You have God who continuously love you. Then the faith will help you, enable you, empower you to understand His power, and you have the gift of the Holy Spirit, the joy and peace. So today, as disciples ask, we also ask Jesus, Lord, increase our faith. God is going to increase your faith today and helping you to understand all the situations of your life, all the obstacles that you are facing in your life. And ask Jesus, ask the Holy Spirit, increase our faith. Then we'll become better disciples and better servants of God that God is proclaiming in today's gospel. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.